Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In the previous video, I gave you the task to recognize ism, fail, harf, and muannas, muzakkar, also muzaf and muzafilay from the first ruku of chapter Surah Baqarah from Quran. But it's better in starting that I also complete your task in a live video, so you will get the idea how to find out ism, fail and harf by implementing all those rules which you have already learned in the previous videos of muzaf, muzaf ilayh, ism, fail and harf. And inshallah, from now we will daily complete, I will daily give you some task on the basis of chapters which we will discuss on the video. So from now, in every video you will receive a task along with that video. So I request you. So first let's start from the beginning, that in the beginning of the first video we have learned that the whole Arabic language is just made up of three things. First one is called ism, second one is called fail, and the last one is called harf. So this video will be categorized in three part. In first part we are going to find out ism, fail and harf. Then in second part we will find out muzakkar and muannas. And then the last part we will find out muzaf and muzaf ilay inshallah from this Quran. So it's starting from alif lam. So just leave alif lam, because we don't have any idea till now regarding this alif lam. But if you can say that this is a harf, because alif lam and mim is a harf. Okay, we don't have any idea about zalika, so just leave zalika. Al kitab is ism. Why al kitab is ism? Because having alif lam on it, and we know that alif lam is the sign of ism. So if any words having alif lam on it will be ism. La raiba, we don't know about la, neither we know about anything about raiba, so just leave la raiba. Fihi, we know that fi is from harfe jar, and harfe is the one of the property of ism. So no, we understand that if fi is on any word, then we can say that word is ism. So fi is here, fi is on he. Okay, so here he is, yeah, that is a ha is harfe jar. Ha is ism here. Why it is ism? Because having harfe jar fi on it. Okay, hudan is ism. Why it is ism? Because having tanween on it, and we know that dual pesh is known as tanween, which is one of the sub property or sign of ism. So if any word having tanween on it, we can say that is ism. Lil muttaqin is also ism. Why? Because here are two properties on the same word. First one is lam harfe jar is on the ism, which on this word, which is also the part of ism, which is also the sign of ism, and also it have alif lam on it. Okay, so it's also have alif lam on it. This means this word having two property of ism. One is alif lam and second one is harfe jar. That's why this is definitely ism. So in the first line we have al kitab ism, ha ism, hudan ism, and lil muttaqin ism. So you can see that in the first word the first word consists 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 words combined together to form a one sentence, in which we have 1 2 3 and 4th word is ism. Okay, in the next line, let's skip alladhina. Yu'minun, what is yu'minun? So we haven't studied about the property of fail. So we are not able to find out yuminun. So just leave yuminun. Bilghaib. Bilghaib is ism. Why? Because having harf jar on it. Okay. That is ba harf jar on it, and it also have alif lam on it. This is non muzaf muzaf ilay. Okay. This is ism. Okay, we will talk about muzaf muzaf ilay later. Just this is for now. This is ism. Why? Because having harf jar on it, that is ba and alif lam on it. Yuqimun. Just leave this. As-salat ism because of having alif lam on it. Wow, leave it. Mimma, leave it. Razaqnahum. Okay, so razaqnahum, we don't know anything about this, so skip this. Yunfiqun, skip this. So in the second line we have only two ism, as-salat and bilghaib. There is not only two ism, but for till now we have what we have learned. So what we have learned, by which we can only able to find out only two ism from this verse. Okay, on next verse, skip allazina yu'minuna bima unzila, skip ilayka. So ilayka is ism. Why ilayka is ism? Because ila is one of harf jar. So harf jar is only added to ism. So this means kaf is 100% ism. That's why ila is having on kaf. When the ila and kaf mix together, then is pronounced ilayka. Okay, min is harf jar, qablika, that is ism. Why? Because harf jar is only added to ism. Bil akhirati ism. Why? Because having alif lam and also having harf jar on it. Hum, skip this. Yuqinun, skip. Ulaika. Okay, here having some trouble. So ulaika, we know nothing about this, so let's skip this. Ala is harf jar. This means any word which is just after ala will be 100% ism. Why? Because harf jar and harf jar only added to ism. So hudan here is ism. Why? Because having it also have two property. First one is having a tanween on it, which is one of the property of alif ism, and ala is also added. That's why hudan having two property for being ism. First one is ala and second one is tanween. Okay, min, this is harf jar, so that means the word have just after harf jar will be ism. So rabbihim, it's ism. Okay, ulaika, skip this. Humul al muflihun ism. Why? Having alif lam on it. Inna allazina, we know nothing about inna allazina, skip. Kafaru, skip. Sawaun ism, having tanween on it. Alayhim ism. Why? Because Allah is a harf jar, so Allah is added to him, so this means him is ism. Anzartahum, skip this. Am lam tundirhum, skip. La yuminun, we know nothing about this yet. Khatamallahu, Allah is ism, because Allah is by saying Allah. Alif lam is also added here. Or you can say just Allah is ism. Allah harf jar, this means kulubihim is ism. Allah is harf jar, this means sam'ihim is ism. Allah is harf jar, this means absarihim ism. Gishabatun, having tanween on it, this means this is ism. Lahum is ism because la is harf jar added to whom, this means lahum is ism. Ism. Azabun, having tanween on it, this mean ism. Azimun, having tanween on it, this mean ism. So we have only learned two chapter from Ilmun Nah, and we are able to find out the ism from sentence. So this we have achieved lot. Okay, mashallah. Now we are able to find out ism. Okay, so why what about fail and what about harf? How can we find ism? Fail and harf by knowing the sign of ism. We are only able to find ism. So how can we find out harf and fail? We will only able to find out exact fail when we will learn about fail, and in which subjects we learn about fail in ilmu sarf. Now we are learning ilmu nah, where we only deal with ism and harf. So the main focus of ilmu nah is only on ism. Okay, so when we start ilmu sarf, then we will able to recognize the fail also. And now inshallah from this video we will read two or three chapter from ilmu sarf also, so we are able to understand whole the ism and fail from this verse. Okay,
So first one, we have already find out the ism on ism from this. Okay, now we have to find muzakkar and muannas from this. So first, what is muzakkar and muzakkar and muannas is the categorization of ism only on the basis of gender. This means we have already find out lot of ism from the this one ruku from Surah Baqarah. So we are only going to find out which one is ism, which ism is male and which ism is female. So Al-Kitab is the first ism. This is Muzakkar, this is male. Why? Because it doesn't have any property of sign of ism, any property or sign of being oneness on it. Okay, Al-Lil Muttaqin is also ism, but it doesn't have any, it's Muzakkar. Why? Because it doesn't have any property of oneness on it. Hudan is also ism and it is Muzakkar. Why? Because it doesn't have any property of muannas. Fihi is, he is a ism and it is Muzakkar. Why? Because this it doesn't have any property and sign of muannas on it. Okay, so Bilghaib is Muzakkar and ism. Why? Because it doesn't have also any sign of muannas. As-Salatu is ism and it is muannas. Why? Because having golta, round shape ta in the ending of it, this is the one of the property of muannas. That's why As-Salat is muannas. Okay, Ilaik Muzakkar, Min Qablika Muzakkar, Bilakhirati muannas, having golta in its end. Hudan, we have dealt with this. Al-Muflihun Muzakkar, doesn't have any sign of muannas. Sawaun, what is Sawaun? It's Muzakkar or muannas? We say that it's muannas. Why it's muannas? Because it's have alif e mamduda. Okay, that is alif after hamza. So this is alif e mamduda. So it's have a property of muannas, and it, because alif e mamduda is one of the property of muannas. Kulubihim muzakkar, samihim muzakkar, absarihim muzakkar, gishawatun muannas. Why? Because I mean golta, azabun muzakkar, azimun muannas. So we have find out the ism. We have find out the male and female, that is muzakkar and muannas, from all the ism. Now what we have learned? We have learned about muzaf and muzaf ilay. So we are going to find out which one is muzaf and muzaf ilay. For understanding and finding out the muzaf and muzaf ilay, we have to understand that muzaf and muzaf ilay will be comes together. You can say that the muzaf is here and the muzaf ilay will be after one or two sentence later. No, muzaf and muzaf ilay always comes together. If there is muzaf just after muzaf, there will be muzaf ilay, and if there is any muzaf ilay, then just before muzaf ilay, there will be muzaf. Then we can say that this is muzaf muzaf ilay, because muzaf and muzaf ilay always comes together. There is no difference with, there is no gap between muzaf and muzaf ilay. First thing. Second thing, the i'rab of muzaf ilay will be always zair, that is zair on it. Okay, and there is only two reasons for any ism to having zair on it. First one is having harf e jar added to in added in the starting of that ism, or second one for having zair on any ism, that is it's having have muzaf before it. So that's why that ism having muzaf before it will be muzaf ilay. So we are now from this first ruku, we will only focus with the ism which having zair on it. Why? Because muzaf ilay is always having zair on it. So we don't have to find each ism, that which one is muzaf and muzaf ilay. Why? Because we know that the default i'rab and the permanent i'rab of muzaf ilay is harf, is zair on it. So if any ism having zair, then we will judge and then we will check that either is this ism is muzaf ilay or this ism is having zair because of harf jar on it. So first one is Al-Kitab, it's have pesh, so we don't need to check this Al-Kitab, that it is muzaf or muzaf ilay, because we know that muzaf ilay having zair on it. So we are going to skip this. Fihi is, what is, we know that the muzaf ilay having zair on it. So is he is also ha is also having zair here. So we can say that this is muzaf ilay. No, we can't say that this is muzaf ilay. Why? Because ha having zair because of harf e jar, not because of being muzaf ilay. Okay, allazina yu'minuna bil ghaib. So just check, this is غائب. غائب has also زیر. So we can say that, is we, do we can say that this is مضاف الیہ? No. Why? We cannot say that this is مضاف الیہ. Because having زیر on غائب is because of حرف جر, not of because of مضاف. Okay. So we can say, we cannot say that this is مضاف الیہ. Why? Because being a مضاف الیہ, we have, there is also مضاف which is just before مضاف الیہ. So here بالغائب, just before بالغائب is يؤمنون which cannot be مضاف. Okay. And this is not مضاف الیہ because this doesn't have مضاف on before it, but it's have a حرف زر. That's why غائب get the اعراب of زیر, that is كسرة on it. As-salat is also ism, but we are not going to find out this is ism, this is muzaf or muzaf ilay. Why? Because we know that the muzaf ilay will be always zero on it. So we are only going to focus on the ism which having zero on it. So here bil akhirati, it's also having zero. So do we can say that this is muzaf ilay? No. Why we cannot say this is muzaf ilay? Because it doesn't have muzaf. Harf jar is added to akhira. That's why harf jar gave this ism zero, not being a muzaf ilay. Give this akhira zair. Okay, there are lot of ism, but there are no muzaf and muzaf ilay in first ruku. So in the first ruku of book, first ruku of Surah Baqara, we don't have any muzaf ilay, but there is a confusion among the students understanding muzaf and muzaf ilay. So I'm going to show you some example of muzaf ilay from one of the Arabic book which is included in your syllabus. So this will also help you to understand muzaf and muzaf ilay properly. Okay, so do we have muzaf? Yes, see here. Okay, suppose that I don't know about this is muzaf ilay. I'm just circling it because we are going to discuss on this. So how can I understand that this is muzaf ilay? So first we will see this i'rab, that is al-kawkab. What is this? This is al-kawkab. So why al-kawkab has zair on it? We know that zair is only added to any ism if that ism having harf jar on its starting, or second reason for having zair on any ism, that is this is that ism will be muzaf ilay. So al kawkab have zair on it. So is there any harf jar is added to ism? No, there is no harf jar, no such harf jar is added to ism. This means this ism definitely will be muzaf ilay. So if this is muzaf ilay, then there also have been muzaf ilay which is just before so if this is muzaf ilay, then there will be a ism just before muzaf ilay, that is called muzaf. So let's find out muzaf. So this is muzaf. Why we are calling this is muzaf? Because the ism is responsible for giving harf this muzaf is here responsible for giving zair to this ism. Okay, so I'm now remind all the rules for muzaf and muzaf ilay. First rule, muzaf always comes before muzaf ilay. So here muzaf ilay and this is muzaf. Here muzaf comes before muzaf ilay. First rule is completed. Second rule, muzaf ilay doesn't muzaf doesn't have alif lam and tanween on it. Here rabbu doesn't have alif lam, nor it have any tanween on it. So second rule is also completed. Okay, so we have two rule. First, muzaf ilay comes before muzaf comes before muzaf ilay. Rabbu is comes before al kawkab. Rabbu doesn't have alif lam and tanween on it. So this is muzaf. And what is the rules for being muzaf ilay? Muzaf ilay always come just after rab muzaf. So here al kawkab, that is muzaf ilay, just come after rabbu muzaf. And muzaf ilay having zair on it. So here muzaf ilay al kawkab has zair on it. And we know that there is only two reasons for any ism having zair on it, having jar on it. First one, harf jar is added to ism, and second, that ism will be muzaf, and the ism before muzaf ilay will that ism will be muzaf ilay, and the ism which is before muzaf ilay will be muzaf. So here no harf jar is added, نو حرف زر از ایڈیڈ ٹو اسم دس مین الکوکب از مضاف الی اینڈ ربو از مضاف سو دیر از ایگزامپل آف مضاف مضاف الی ہیئر آلسو سی دیٹ رب القمر رب القمر سو القمر ہیونگ زیر آن اٹ وائی از اٹس ہیونگ زیر آن اٹ ٹو ریزن فار بینگ زیر حرف جر اور مضاف الی دیر از نو حرف جر دس مین قمر از ڈیفینیٹلی مضاف الی And if Qamar is Muzaf Ilay, then the ism just before Muzaf Ilay will be Muzaf. So ism just before Al-Qamar is Rabbu. This means Rabbu will be Muzaf. And if it's Muzaf, then there are some rules. What? Alif Lam is not added. So Rabbu doesn't have Alif Lam. Tanween will be not added. Then here Tanween is not added. This means Rabbu is Muzaf and Qamar is Muzaf, Muzaf Ilay. So what is the meaning of Rabbul Qamar? So we don't have to... translate this yet but we have to know that so what will be the translation of muzaf muzaf ilay because we know that the muzaf muzaf ilay is the one of the part of incomplete sentence one of the type of incomplete sentence so what will be the meaning of muzaf muzaf what will be the translation of muzaf muzaf ilay so this translation will definitely incomplete so qamar means moon okay and rab means rab okay so rabbul qamar this means the sustainer of moon okay so here say rabbu shams muzaf muzaf ilay rabbul alamin muzaf muzaf ilay okay so here by seeing alamin you can get confused because alamin doesn't have alamini so why this doesn't have alamini so we can say that we have already learnt about the types of irab there are two types of irab first one is harkati and second one is harfi so here harfi irab is added to it we didn't read about the harfi irab so you might get confused so inshallah in the next video we are going to deal with this type of irab okay so I understand I hope I made you explain everything properly so let me give you other task that is you will start from wa minan nas okay From here, just start find out ism, okay, muzaf muzaf ilay and muzakkar muannas. And in this video, I am also going to tell you the property of ism and a property of ism and fail also. So this will be very easy for us. Let me see. Do we have any notes regarding? Okay so here we have a property of ism that is alif lam we have read about that then harf jar tanween gol round shape ta and we haven't studied about dual that is tasniya and jama so inshallah we will deal with we didn't read musnad ilay yes we have dealt with muzaf Inshallah, soon we will be able to understand more of Sifat. Okay, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 signs which we haven't read yet. Inshallah, we will be. Now, let me tell you about some property of fail also. Okay, but before knowing the property of fail, we need to learn about fail. So let me skip this in the next video we will start al-musarf then you will be able to understand whole the property of ism because before knowing the property of fail you have to understand what is fail so for knowing the fail inshallah we will to discuss on or study about al-musarf in which we will discuss about fail okay assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh just complete your task and this is the very beginning of you And you have done very good job because only by knowing 2 and 3 videos you are able to find out the ism which ism from Quran which is a very great opportunity for you so inshallah this will become very successful so from now just try to find out the ism muzakkar muannas and muzaf muzaf ilay as I shown you in the video okay jazakumullahu khair wa hasanal jaza assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi